GoPro Hero3.
Hero3 Black Edition.
Yeah.
There's three editions. This one's the top of the line.
Okay.
The new things on this version are that it allows for slightly higher resolution. It does 4K at 15 frames per second, and it does, it fascinates little children because it's hilarious with Lexicam, and it does a variety of different different resolutions. And you want to do this review, Lexi? You want to do this review? Okay. So you want to tell everybody what this does? What this does?
Daddy!
A couple upgrades from the old one. It does low light performance a little bit better. It has 4K resolution, albeit only at 15 frames per second. It's still somewhat useful at 4K, but you know, it's not designed for that right now. I'm usually filming at the 2.7K, and that does it up to 30 frames per second, I believe. We're usually filming at 24 frame here. It also does full 1080p and 720p at 120 frames per second, so we can do a lot of cool slow-mo stuff that we might try later. Lexi, what do you think?
Yes.
Okay, so the GoPro Hero Black, it also has a Wi-Fi remote, which I have around here somewhere, a Wi-Fi remote right here, which, here Lexi, you can play with this, and it allows us to turn it on and off, and it has all the settings there somehow, and you can pretty much mount these anywhere. The new one is actually really flat, as you can see here.
Fear me.
As you can see, it's actually really, really small, and you can fit it on a lot of things. It's also waterproof with the waterproof door, and it's a great action cam. I've been using it to film, you know, B-roll for the various things I do, like .com/Pho and Knapp's Hockey Blog, and, you know, just using it for everyday random stuff. So, yeah. Mm-hmm, totally. And if you're looking for an action cam, particularly one that's very durable, gets great low light performance, and has lots of shooting range, shooting modes, you know, give the GoPro Hero3 Black a try. And that's the gadget of the week.
Really?